是不是你身边的小花和抽筋？ our chief apostle, Apostle John T. Higgins.
Going on the surface, you start going deeper, you start to go higher. mean, you, once you start going, you got to start picking up the pace. And you got to keep it going, and you can't take a break. You got to keep it going. Many of you have not gotten where you need to go because you decided to take a break in the middle of the intensity. Father says, you start to pick it quick. It means these words, I am the storm. Be quickened. I am the storm. See, you keep thinking the storm is the enemy. Why won't you be the storm? Because you don't want to be quickened to be the storm. You'd rather be on the other end of the storm. But I tell you today, be quickened, for I am storm. Stop going through the storm and start bringing the storm. 1 Peter chapter 3. For the eyes of the Lord are over the righteous, and his ears are upon open unto their prayers. But the face of the Lord is against them that do evil. So let's get this right. You sitting there and getting attitude with people all the time, always offended, always got an issue and a problem. You're doing evil. See, people think doing evil is going out shooting somebody. That's the lesser of all evils. Attitude, bad attitude is the major of all evils. Because bad attitude leads to everything else. Without bad attitude, you have no gasoline for the bomb. So you come across a lot of people that are evil, and the reason how you know that they're evil is because they always got a bad attitude. They always party. They always got something rotten to say. Always saying something about somebody. Always talking about somebody's bad situation and their bad situation. Always talking about what can't be done. Always talking about what is not right. Always talking about this and that. Always got an issue with somebody or something. The Lord has given them that do evil. You are doing evil. Some people think that doing that man or woman is doing evil. No, you doing that. You doing an attitude. That's evil. You are laying down with attitude. You are waking up with attitude. That is your mate. You don't need any physical thing to be with you because you filled up with a whole bunch of spiritual thing that's walking with you. Bad attitude. You dine with it romantically. You wake up to it, chapter 3, verse 12. You wake up to it romantically. You just be loving it. You go and you take it to work with you. It's in the car with you. It is your best friend. It is your bestie. Oh, yes. You give it plenty of time. You never miss a moment. You never miss a moment. To be with attitude. You love attitude. So how do you say that, Apostle? Because you spend so much time with it. You in the shower with it? Oh, how wonderful. Bubbles and all. Yes. You have it in your closet. Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who's the loveliest of them all? It's me, it's you, it's you and me and you. Oh. You got it all over your Facebook. It's your family portrait. Oh, yes, you do. Your attitude is down to the store together. You run through Amazon together. You wash clothes together. Don't say you don't have a man or a woman. You do. It's called attitude. Bad attitude. That's what they call it. I ain't got nobody. Yes, you do. Your attitude is doing just fine. Your bad attitude is doing an amazing job together. You are going worldwide together. Doing evil. Oh, you are building together. Relationships going. You know, you've already conquered that. And you can treat some, if you can carry somebody with you as much as you carry that attitude, you would be heaven on earth right now. If you treated everybody as good as you, if you were so consistent with people as you are with bad attitude, you'd have a whole lot of folks following you, because bad attitude hasn't left you yet. All these years you've been trying, but you can't get rid of them. You can't get the divorce. You are married to that attitude. That's why you ain't doing a walk down the aisle. You've already walked down the aisle of bad attitude. In fact, you and bad attitude got married somewhere around 3 or 4 years old. Relationship goals, you have had a long relationship. Okay. For the eyes are open to righteous, so you think God is looking at you. He's really not looking at you. He's looking at you in that relationship. There will be no other gods before me. Uh-oh. You wonder what's going on. He's been sitting there looking at you and you in a bad attitude for years. Don't you think he's about sitting in that? He's about to be a homebreaker. He's about to break it up. So congratulations for Valentine's Day. Give yourself some flowers. You and bad attitude can go down to Penny Hines. Yeah. And when you get your income tax check, you and bad attitude can buy you a new car. You and bad attitude will be going shopping together as you have been, assume the position. So you can stop complaining that you don't have nobody. You got somebody. It's called bad attitude. You are officially announced today that you have had somebody the whole time. You can stop lying now and say you don't have anybody. You've always had somebody. Nobody didn't feel like sharing with you in a bad attitude. Uh-oh. Many have tried to break the relationship up with you in bad attitude and have failed. So you are not by yourself. You are with yourself. You and bad attitude. Facebook people, you can stop this right. Your selfies is wonderful because you are showing you in bad attitude. I have been enjoying you and your mate for many years, seeing all the many faces of you and your mate bad attitude. Your Instagram is full of you and bad attitude. You are not alone. So you can stop lying, talk about you ain't got nobody. But if you want somebody new, honey, you got to get rid of bad attitude. You got to give him the eviction. You got to put bad attitude out your house. Because the goodness can't come to visit you. Nobody's coming to visit you with bad attitude. I don't want to see you at the picnic. I do not want to see you at the family reunion. I do not want to see you over at the Christmas tree. I do not want to see you on the 4th of July. I do not want to be there with you in bad attitude. I refuse to share you with people with bad attitude. That's what my father says. He will not share you in bad attitude any longer. So you need to make up your mind, do you want him or do you want them? Christians, you say you don't believe in the threesome. Yes, you do. for you. Attitude be like, babe, I got this. I got it. So you like, would you like some ice cream? And attitude said, what do you mean? Yeah, they're trying to talk about me. And then attitude said, babe, I got this. And what you say? What you saying to us? I know you ain't talking about us. Because for real, we can take it there, okay? We can take it there. Nobody want none of your stinking ice cream. We all eat dessert. Well, see, that's the problem. You're trying to make me like everybody else. But don't worry. Bring the whole dish off. Shut up. I got this. Now, I'm going to tell you again. We're not like everybody else. You offer me some ice cream next week, but today we not have it. But babe, come on. I really don't want some. You don't want ice cream right now. Let me tell you something. You always in my face trying to say something, trying to act like I can afford my own ice cream. Matter of fact, I got some Haagen Dazs at the house. Attitude, shut up. No, we don't eat that. That is it. Well, I'm about to get some anyway. Well, all right, go ahead. Give me two bowls to go. And hurry up, too. If I really must have this ice cream, then you need to hurry up, give me two bowls to go. So attitude is full of dust. Anybody want to get rid of attitude, baby, you got it. You want to have a better Valentine's Day. And the reason why it's not happening is because the face of the Lord is against them that do evil. So it says, what is the meaning of righteousness? And the meaning of righteousness is, what is the meaning of upright? So righteousness took me to upright. And so I went and I looked up what upright says, erect or vertical, as in position or posture. So you're not standing up. Here it is again, you're laying down. So bad attitude, your friend keeps you laying down. So bad attitude possibly be getting something. Saying you ain't getting any because you giving it up with bad attitude all the time. Man. Well, they get it. They just, that's the problem. They've been getting too much bad attitude. You've been getting too much bad attitude. Stop fornicating with bad attitude. You're fornicating with bad attitude. It's time to get up. It's time to get off your back and get on your feet. I said we going deep. The breath of vertical is in the position of posture, so you need to get up. So that means you got to be quickened. Something in your spirit say, I'm tired of dealing with bad attitude. It ain't been good for me. I got to get rid of this thing. I got to get rid of bad attitude. Been holding me down. Bad attitude been keeping me down. Bad attitude been keeping me broke. Bad attitude been keeping me in the same situation. Bad attitude has not been good to me. I got to quicken myself. I got to run fast enough to get away from bad attitude. Because if I don't move fast enough, bad attitude gonna hold. So and then he said that bad to hold on to your leg because you're moving too slow. You're supposed to jump over him and keep running. Raise or direct, vertically or upward. See, when you are getting away from that attitude, then you become quick and you will start to go upward. You will start to get some momentum. You will start going up, because you're not laying down no more. You start looking up, being up, thinking up. My God, doing things that pick you up. You start being about to up. You start going upward. You are upward bound. Adhering to rectitude, righteous, honest or just. It says honest or just. You don't have to be so honest, but you could be just. An upright person. If you could just make it up in your mind to be just, you won't need. See, bad attitude is about injustice. Bad attitude does all injustice. Feeling like it's being, justice hasn't been done for it. So bad attitude is all about feeling like it ain't get its fair share. That's right. You don't feel, so bad attitude makes you feel it because you feel like somebody is violating you. That means you're not getting justice. And bad attitude won't stop until you feel as though you got justice. What they gonna think they gonna do. just put you deeper in. Some people say love and basketball, why did you make the shot? See some things that go on. Oh my God. If you be the follower of that which is good, why stop chasing that attitude, trying to see if they're cheating on you? Let that joke evolve. Stop. If you follow God the way you run behind that attitude, where you going? Where you taking us? Where you going? Wait a minute. Hold on. I'm too happy today. Where you at? Stuff is going too right. I'm too happy today. That attitude, where you at? Stuff is going too well. Is it about to go bad? My God, what's where you at? I don't know. Something feels weird today. Something ain't quite right today. Where you at? Where you at? Oh, where you at? Oh, I found you. Okay, we're back. We're back. Now what you say, what you want to say today? What you want to say today? I was quiet yesterday. What you want to say today? I was quiet yesterday. What you want to say? sacrificial divine, you're going to have people wasting days that's going to try to make you afraid. They're going to talk to you like the devil. And you're going to say, oh, are you sure you can do that? How are you going to do that? Where's your money at? How's your credit? You got a five, you got a zero score. What you going to do? How you plan on doing all this stuff that you know you only made this amount of money? How you plan on doing this when you ain't working over, right? How you planning on doing this? How can you be real smart in school? I mean, how you going to do this? So you're not going to be smart in school, but God said you are an excellent school. God said you can do it all. God said you can do it all. But they're going to try to tell you God don't know what he's talking about. And see, you got to believe what God said. God said you are smart. God said you are smart. He said you are smart. So stop believing what they say. You are smart. You are a genius in the name of Jesus. You can do all the work. You can do everything. Nothing can stop you. Don't believe what they say. Prove them wrong. Don't believe them teachers. Don't believe them namesayers. If they say you bad, prove them that you're not. Prove them you good. They tell you can't do it, prove you can do all of it. They say it ain't possible, say it's all possible. See, you gotta be quickened. See, quickened means you defy the devil. It means that you tell them that you know that you can, that you can, that you know that you can, that you know that you can, that you can, that you know that you can, that you will, 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 in the middle of the will, that you will. You got to start talking to the terror, telling it off with a God attitude. The only reason why terror came to you is because he's trying to make you get back with bad attitude. Terror comes to make you get back into the relationship with bad attitude. You know, bad attitude is just about out your house. You're going to put out the last bag just about. And just when you got the last bag to put out the door, here comes terror to make you think you should take it back. You'd be like, oh, shoot. Maybe I should go back to that same job I don't like. Maybe I should go back in there and go back to laying in the room and not doing nothing. Maybe I should just go and sit down and everything because it ain't really working anyway. Maybe I should get away from that place and other people because it ain't nothing working anyway. Maybe have walked away from that bad relationship, a bad attitude, and went back and got back and got engaged to him and got married again. And now he's punishing them for leaving in the first place. Because terror came, he said, bad attitude, I'm going to help you. Let me go scare him up a little bit. I'll get him back for you. Oh, you're learning something today. So bad attitude to come over and say, listen, so I ain't trying to get away from having a good attitude. mother-in-law just gonna nag you about it. See, I thought you was good with her. Ain't been good to you all these years. Like, why you gotta leave? Why you gotta leave that attitude? I mean, didn't he keep people off you? Was nobody beating you up anymore? Taking any more stuff from you anymore? So you had a bad attitude. They stopped beating on you the minute you picked up that attitude. That attitude protected you from everything. And you won't turn around, you won't try to get out the family now just because you don't got over with that other people, the other them church folks. That's what you gonna do. You gonna leave with that, you gonna leave the bad attitude now? What about the children of bad attitude? You gonna leave them too? Yeah, what you gonna do? You gonna leave disobedience now? And you gonna leave those defiance too? You gonna leave disobedience and defiance? You gonna leave your whole family and all that? Because ain't what this fun is not doing what they told you to do, not being controlled. What is fun? Not being controlled. You can do what you wanted to do. You gonna leave do what you wanna do to go with the JSUS, the capital G-O-D? And trouble keeps troubling you. Keeps talking to you. See, now if you go back to bad attitude, that'd be a problem that got broke in the first place. Did you ever think about that? What if they're wrong? What if you just had a bad attitude and the car didn't go? Understand? Maybe if you wasn't up there riding back and forth the same place, then your car would have been. You know what I'm saying? You up there being all nice and stuff and then your car breaks. Why is that? You up there serving like that. Why you trying to bring you up there serving sitting at that restaurant? Why you doing that? Understand? Then all of a sudden you start talking with a bad attitude. Yeah, that's right. They got me up here. I don't got a little bit of money and stuff. This truck in there, I just got some money. Now the truck is already going down. All the money's going out and everything. They run around there being happy and stuff. But I'm extra dinners and stuff. I don't know how to do this next week. sitting at night. Nasty old thing, naked night, knocking on the door. What you doing? Can I come in? They treat you bad all day. Come on, you know I'm gonna love you, right? Let me in. He said, come on in, bad attitude, and listen. Now, you know what they were doing today, right? You know what they said to you, right? Yeah, that's what they did. They hate you. Yeah, they sure do. Yeah. And then, you know what? But you know what you're going to do tomorrow. What are you going to do tomorrow? Are you going to let them know you are not blind? That's what you're going to do. Yeah, you're right. That's why I'm about to stop being soft. I'm going to let them know when I get into you. Watch. Watch. And I got in at 5 o'clock in the morning, too. Well, they're going to see. They're going to feel it all day. All day they gonna feel my 5 o'clock woes. I'm gonna let them know that I've been up till 5 o'clock in the morning so that stupid chick couldn't shut her mouth. Now I gotta be here. And then I gotta get in early. They talk about late. I ain't seeing them at 12. It don't matter if they're the bosses or not. It don't matter. I'm coming in. your finance. Don't have coffee on your finance.
Check. My God means that I'm clear. There's nothing blocking me. I write the check. My
are, you are, you are, you are. My God, they speak evil of you. They are. All of y'all has been speaking bad about the house of God, the house of God, the men and women of God, this house. You speak, if you owe a gospel child support check, you need to go out there. You owe, you owe, you owe, you owe. I suggest that you go and start paying and paying and paying, because Quicken is showing up. Quicken will be knocking on your door. Quicken has been knocking on your door. Quicken is knocking on your door. It's time for you to open up and pay your bill. For it's better, if the will of God be so, that you suffer well doing than for evil doing. God is telling you, and I'm closing, verse 17. For it's better if the will of God be so, that you suffer for well doing than for evil doing. You should be joyful at the fact that you can sacrifice. Because there are some people can't sacrifice nothing, but their suffering is over. That means their sacrifice is over, and now they are with Father, or they are with the devil. At the end of the day, long as you're able to sacrifice, that means you live. And long as you keep living and you keep sacrificing, that means you got the right relationship. And long as you got the right relationship, you can be quickened. And long as you be quickened, you can collect the gospel child support that's due you. I'm talking to somebody there. Long as you be quickened, that means you can receive the things that you are supposed to have. You can receive them quickly. Quicken. Quickly. Quicken. Quickly. When it seems like you were wrong, you can get that money back quickly. When something goes wrong in your house, and get repaired quickly. My God, when your pocket gets empty and get filled up again, quickly. My God, when it seems like you were sick, you'll stay sick for a second. Quickly. My God, when you had a head in your life for a second. Quickly. When people started getting on your nerves, you'll die there for a second. Quickly. My God, you're about to be quickly. That means everything's going to happen quickly. The selection's going to happen quickly. Said it had to happen one day of the week. It could happen every day of the week. I'm telling you right out here right now, Father is collecting and he's sending them checks. It's bigger than the stimulus check. It's bigger than any check that ever could have hit you. Because this check is going to cover the whole realm of everything. From health, sickness, poverty, your household, housing, broken cars, and all the other goofiness in between. He is signing these things up to make sure these things get right. He is collecting right now. See, when you got away from the bad relationship, when you broke up a bad relationship, he owes some back child support. The back gospel child support. And God is getting ready to collect all the back child support, all the things that bad relationship has taken away from you. All the things that bad relationship has taken away from you. He is about to collect all that has been taken away from you. That he might bring us to God. To bring you closer to God. To deliver you to God. From being put to death. From being put to death. Around and you got a whole relationship with
be saved. Amen. Amen. Amen.